Have you ever wondered what makes your favorite app so smart? Or how that self-driving car knows when to stop? Today, we are diving deep into the world of machine learning and deep learning. Last time, we discussed the key differences and applications of these technologies. Now, let's go beyond the basics and explore their advanced concepts and nuances. Understanding these topics is key to grasping the future of technology. So, stick around as we unravel the advanced aspects of machine learning and deep learning. First off, let's recap what machine learning is. Machine learning is a subset of artificial intelligence that allows systems to learn from data and improve over time. It includes various algorithms that can identify patterns and make predictions based on that data. Now, let's talk about deep learning. Deep learning is a specialized area within machine learning that uses neural networks to mimic how the human brain works. These neural networks consist of multiple layers, enabling them to process data more effectively. But why is deep learning important? Because it excels in handling large amounts of unstructured data, like images and speech. Let's explore some advanced concepts in machine learning first. We'll start with supervised learning. In supervised learning, the model learns from labeled data. For example, if we want to teach a model to recognize cats in pictures, we show it many images of cats and not cats, and label them accordingly. Then there's unsupervised learning, where the model works with unlabeled data to find structure on its own. A great example here is clustering, which groups similar data points together. This can be super useful for customer segmentation in marketing. Next, we have reinforcement learning. In reinforcement learning, an agent learns by taking actions in an environment, receiving feedback in the form of rewards or penalties. Think of it like training a dog. You reward it when it sits and scold it when it barks unnecessarily. Now, let's transition to deep learning. Deep learning relies heavily on the concept of neural networks. Neural networks consist of interconnected nodes, or neurons, organized in layers, input, hidden, and output layers. The input layer receives the data, the hidden layers transform it, and the output layer produces results. An important term here is backpropagation. This is the method used to update the weights of the network based on errors made during predictions. Let's look at convolutional neural networks, CNNs. CNNs are particularly good for analyzing visual data. In fact, they're used in many facial recognition systems and image classification tasks. Another type of neural network is recurrent neural networks, RNNs. RNNs are excellent for handling sequential data, making them ideal for tasks like language translation or time series forecasting. You might be wondering, how do these two approaches work together? Well, in real-world applications, machine learning and deep learning often complement each other. For example, a business might use machine learning models for customer analytics. At the same time, they can employ deep learning for image recognition in their mobile app. This combination leads to more robust solutions. Let's also explore some practical applications of these advanced concepts. In healthcare, machine learning algorithms can analyze patient data to identify diseases early. Deep learning models are transforming radiology by detecting anomalies in images like X-rays and MRIs. In finance, machine learning can detect fraud patterns, while deep learning can predict stock market trends using vast amounts of historical data. If you're interested in getting started with these technologies, here's a simple step-by-step guide. Start by learning the basics of Python, as it's the most widely used programming language in this field. Then, familiarize yourself with libraries like scikit-learn for machine learning and TensorFlow or PyTorch for deep learning. Next, practice by working on small projects or datasets. Kaggle is a great platform for finding interesting datasets and challenges. Finally, join communities and forums to connect with others who share your interests. Don't forget that continuous learning is key in this field. And remember, hands-on experience is often the best teacher. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up. Leave a comment below about which topic you want us to explore next. And don't forget to subscribe to Code in Jech for more content like this. Until next time, keep coding and stay curious.